In the last demonstration I showed you in performance, monitoring performance, we saw an application that was bottlenecked on CPU resources. And we saw that through Query Store, Azure Monitor, through our DMVs. Now let's see how we can maybe scale and accelerate performance for that application very easily in Azure SQL. Okay. Now in front of me here, again, is a familiar tool of SQL Server Management Studio connected to my Azure SQL database. Now let's take a look through T-SQL, how I can see what I would normally see through the portal. I can see the service tier that I deployed. We call that service tier sometimes service level objective or slow. So by running a query against DM user DB resource governance, I mentioned this in a previous video to you, I can see the configuration. I can see here that I've got a general purpose Gen 5 hardware 2V core deployment, and CPU limit shows I've only got two CPUs allocated to this Azure SQL database. I can even use this database property EX function and also see the service level tier I've deployed. So if I wanted to scale this application very easily, what if I could just like bump up my CPUs? That'd be kind of cool. And I can do that through the portal. I can do through T-SQL. Notice here that the alter database command in Azure SQL database has been changed and enhanced to support changing the service objective or the service tier. In this case, I'll kick off this command, and in an asynchronous fashion, I am scaling now my deployment behind the scenes from 2V cores to 8V cores to get better performance. So I can see the progress of this scaling operation by using a DMV or even looking at the Azure portal. And I'll go over here. You can tell that I've already scaled. It's that quick sometimes of an operation that already Azure SQL database has moved my Azure SQL deployment to another infrastructure that supports 8V cores. Let's look and see how that can maybe improve our performance. So back over here, remember our workload we ran using OSTRS. I'm simply going to run that workload again. And then I'm going to go in Management Studio and run the same queries that I ran before. So for example, I'll run DM exec requests. And you can see here that I've got more running queries now than before. Still some SOS schedule yield waits, but more running queries. If I go look at another DMV we looked at before, resource stats, I can see here that even though it thinks I've got 100% CPU utilization, it's because of the time frame that I'm actually running this application that over time, it's actually in the period of time that it's going to run, it takes less CPU percentage. Remember before we had like three rows of 99%. If I go back over here and look at my workload, notice it's already finished. It took a minute and 40 seconds before. Now it takes some 29 seconds to complete the workload. A significant performance improvement just by an easy scale operation in Azure. If we go back over and look at Azure SQL database at Query Store, we will see the difference in comparison. If I look at my top resource performing queries, this was the previous query in this duration. Here is the new query. And you can tell if I hover over here that the average duration time, which was like 5 seconds before, is down to a second. If I even go look at my CPU wait statistics through Query Store as well, and I click on it, I can see that the new query is significantly waiting on less CPU resources. In fact, you can look here in the report and see that the average wait time on CPU is even less than a second, less than a millisecond in this particular case. So you can see that a significant improvement I have gained by just doing a scale operation in Azure. Another way I can look at the scale of this operation and the speed improvement is going back to the portal. So you look in the Azure portal, you can tell when I ran this workload before of the duration of the CPU utilization 100%. Here I can tell that it did peak almost 100%, but the duration was much tinier. So you can even see that it's possible for me to even scale this further out by even adding more CPUs to my environment. And guess what? If I pick serverless as my deploy option, Azure SQL would have automatically scaled my number of CPUs up to my max number automatically for this application without me even doing any manual operations. So here's an example of putting it all together. In the first demonstration I've done previously, I monitored my application, saw it was bottlenecked on CPU resources. Second demonstration, I was able to easily go into the T-SQL, up my number of vCores in a short period of time. I was back up and running, ran the same workload, got a significant performance increase, a much shorter duration of running these queries because I'm not bottlenecked as much in CPUs. And again, serverless could be a great option to avoid even having to do this manually. Check out our next video as we talk more about performance for Azure SQL.